So in order to provide further guidance on the Hashgraph Governance Council, I have here Tom Trowbridge, the president of Hashgraph, in order for us to find out more.
Thanks for having me.
Sorry about that. So, Tom, tell us more about the Hashgraph Governance Council.
Certainly, happy to. So Hashgraph is characterized by open consensus and permission governance. And what we mean by that is at maturity, we expect consensus to be established by millions of nodes distributed globally around the world. Anyone will be able to meet, after meeting minimal criteria of bandwidth, access, and CPU power, join onto the network and participate in providing consensus. But governance we view as separate than consensus. And governance for an enterprise-grade network designed for mission-critical applications we think is best done by enterprises. And so we've established a council of 39 businesses globally distributed to provide that governance.
Got it. So I guess what was your thought process in selecting those institutions that are going to be involved in the council?
We wanted to have global businesses with very well-known brand names that were knowledgeable about distributed ledger technology and that represented both all continents and also as many as 18 different industries. If we'd wanted to populate it with one sector, we could have done so very quickly. But our goal is to have as many different sectors, some of whom and companies who could be competitors and compete with one another, so that the opportunity for collusion or to drive the network one way or another is incredibly low. The other component of this is that these companies are only on the council for a three-year term and have a maximum of two consecutive terms. So it's actually more of a stewardship than it is a perpetual ownership, and the council will also find new members going forward. So while we're involved in selecting the first 39, after that, the council will actually select the subsequent members going forward.
Got it. So I think you might have touched upon this before, but the whole security of the network, I guess, how do the council and also the tokens fit into the network overall?
Certainly. Well, we're a proof of stake model, and what that means is that consensus is established by the nodes. Mm-hmm. If we didn't have a token, any attacker could stand up a third of the nodes and could disrupt consensus. And so a third of the nodes can actually prevent consensus from happening. Now that's both a security feature, which is positive, because should a third of the nodes go offline, you cannot establish consensus, which means you don't run any risk of double spend. That's a positive. The risk is a third of nodes are taken offline by a malicious actor who just wants to shut the network down. And so to prevent that, we have a token and token-weighted voting. So the voting is weighted by the tokens, and that provides the security that makes it incredibly unlikely that the network is compromised.
Got it. Well, Tom, appreciate you taking the time to speak with me. There you have it, folks, the Hashgraph Governance Council.
Thanks for having me.
And now on a final note, the official name of the governing body is the Hedera Hashgraph Council, or HHC. We had originally shot this before the official Hedera Hashgraph announcement, so we wanted to provide this clarification. You can also find out further details on HHC on the Hedera Hashgraph website. Obviously, governance will be key in ensuring the stability of this public ledger, and the HHC presents a new structure that we haven't quite seen yet in other DLTs. This is definitely something that you should keep a close eye on as it evolves. I'm curious to hear on your thoughts and reactions to this, so don't hesitate to leave a comment on this video and let's have a discussion. And finally, I wanted to thank Tom for offering his time. If you want to follow further interviews and gossip on the world powered by Hashgraph, be sure to subscribe to my channel and turn on notifications for future updates. This is The Gossip Guy, signing out. Thanks for watching.